It's a special day. We're doing a kinesiology video. That sports medicine degree is finally about to pay off. So there are over 600 muscles in the human body, and they are a colossal pain in the butt to memorize. And really, just the names and location of these muscles are only one layer of overall anatomy. And if the purpose of this big old squishy sack of meat flesh is to move us through the world and let us pet puppies and support literally every system in our body, then we have to go a little bit deeper. So in this video, we're gonna break down the four big concepts that you're gonna come across when you pop open that anatomy book to the musculoskeletal section. Just the quickest of background first. This is a skeletal muscle. One of the three types of muscle in the body. In order to actually move anything, it needs to attach to your skeleton via tendons. One of those attachment sites is called the origin, while the other is its insertion. Unfortunately, while it would definitely make things simpler, we can't just call one like the distal tendon and the other the proximal tendon, because their labels are actually given off of motion, not location. In general, when the muscle contracts, it's the insertion point that moves towards the origin. Let's check out an example. This dude right here is the sternocleidomastoid, or the SCM, named so because of its origin and insertion. You have one point that hooks in at the sternum and a bit of the clavicle, and another that hooks in at the mastoid process of the skull. So to figure out which one is the origin and which one is the insertion, we have to take a look at its action, which isn't actually as straightforward as it seems. Here's my advice. When you're learning muscle actions, actually do the action. Feel your muscle contract underneath your fingers so that you can really build a mental picture of what's happening with that muscle contraction. And you'll definitely notice this as you go and read more, but like the description for my example muscle, the SCM, is embarrassingly drawn out. Ready? When it acts unilaterally, it provides contralateral cervical rotation and ipsilateral cervical flexion, and bilaterally, cervical flexion, elevation of the sternum, and assistance in forced inhalation. And all of that just says, you have two SCMs. If you flex both of them at the same time, you'll bend your neck. If you only flex one, you'll end up rotating it as well. Again, perform the actions, avoid memorizing sentences. Or not, do you? Either way, in both cases, the chest remains pretty fixed while the skull is moving. So we label the mastoid process the insertion, while the sternum clavicle area is the origin. Now, the sternocleidomastoid is pretty straightforward since it's a really simple shape. But the same rule applies for funkier looking muscles like the pectoralis. The pec major, aka the Terry Crews, has a super wide origin, touching on everything from the sternum, ribs, clavicle, and some connective tissue. But its insertion is a spot on the humerus. And since the muscle's actions bring the humerus either forward or towards the body, its origin is that big chunk of medial tissue, and its insertion is on the humerus. And while it might seem like there are a ton of intricacies in memorizing these components of musculature, if you know the origins and insertions, you can usually figure out the actions and vice versa. Cool, so the last concept that you'll learn in this lesson usually is innervation. Some nerve had to be stimulated in order to get that muscle to fire. And that nerve is the innervation. And you can think about innervation in two main ways. You can either write each muscle and nerve on a flashcard and brute force memorize it, or just picture what group of muscles that nerve matches up with. For example, the oculomotor nerve, one of those 12 cranial nerves, innervates a bunch of those muscles that move the eye. Again, brilliant example of anatomists being terrible namers. So why should you care? I mean, once you got the names of the muscle bellies, you should be golden, right? Well, dude, if you ever want to get into physical therapy or sports medicine, or even just start performing some of these therapies on yourself, then you're gonna need to know eyes and nose in practice. In everything from stretching to strength exercise, having a solid foundation and some pretty precise anatomy is gonna become essential. And having them available just to like pull out of your brain at a moment's notice really ends up saving some time as opposed to having to look all this stuff up. And if you want to continue learning about the human body and hanging out with me, then make sure to subscribe to the channel right there. Maybe even check out a couple of the other videos. You know, like this video, comment your favorite muscle down below. Otherwise, have fun, be good. I'll see you next time.